Vibes. Welcome sa isa na namang episode na siksik, liglig at umaapaw sa saya. Kamusta ang naging araw ninyo? Well, alam niyo naman kasing pag the Timmy Up Show na, oras na para mag-sit back, mag-relax at walang ibang gagawin kundi hintayin at hayaang dumaloy ang good vibes na dala ko for you, for me, and for everyone na merong
insomnia!
Kaya naman huwag natin patagalin pa. Here we go with our nightly inaabangang Yak Dates. For tonight, kwelang usapan naman tayo. May joke noon, basta kulot, sandot, oops! Pero alam natin, hindi totoo yan. Pero for tonight, yung nasa kabilang side of the spectrum naman ng ating pag-uusapan. Totoo bang basta kalbo, guwapo? Let's find out! First on our list of celebs na well-known sa pagiging kalbo, but rocking it walang iba, kundi ang Asia's Got Talent host at aking kaibigan na si Robilson Fernandez. Dati naman daw may buhok itong si Robilson, pero parang mas bagay nga sa kanya ang bald look. Besides, parang mas practical ito dito sa Pilipinas since nasanay siya sa malamig na klima ng California. When he's not busy counting down topics for GMA News TV's Ang Pinaka, Robilson is busy with sports activities to keep him fit.
Ano kaya ang pinaka-love ni Robinson sa isang babae? Baka ako na pala ang hinahanap niya. Guess ka naman sa amin, Papa R!
Next up, isang hot daddy na social media sensation din. That's Doug Kramer, everybody. Nakilala si Doug bilang isang hardcore heartthrob noong UAAP days niya, and then he moved to pro basketball at kalaunay nakilala rin bilang isang very responsible family guy at the head of the very cute Team Kramer. Binata pa lang itong si Doug, talagang naging trademark na niya pagiging kalbo.
Buti na lang na matangkad siya, kundi baka pati ulo niya na dribble na lang kalaban niya, no?
Next, isa pang hardcore heartthrob na tumawid naman from playing ball to modeling and then to acting, si Derek Hubalde. Derek is the son of basketball legend Freddie Hubalde at kaya ng dad niya. First love din ni Derek ang basketball hanggang sa mapansin siya ng casting agents for fashion shows. In 2013, gumanap naman siya sa isang soap opera bilang si Zuma, isang Pinoy monster na naging ahas.
Ooh, alam niyo na yan mga ka-good vibes? Pa-punchline ba ako? Automatic na ako sa ahas ni Derek.
From Derek, punta naman tayo kay Derek. Si Derek Ramsey na tinitirian at object of affection din ng marami. Alam niyo bang sa 8 Bulaga din nagsimula si Derek? He started out as a segment host ng You Bet. And from there, like many others na nagsimula sa EB, maraming nakapansin sa talent and looks ni Derek, which eventually led him to leading man roles sa maraming pelikula. Isa sa mga notable roles ni Derek to date ay ang pelikulang English Only Please, where he played Jenlyn Mercado's leading man.
Pero ang tanong talaga dyan ay kung kamag-anak niya si Miss Elizabeth Ramsey.
Last but definitely not the least, punta naman tayo sa isang funny man na marami ang pinapatawa at pinasasaya, si Wally Bayola. Kung everyday ay laughing out loud tayong lahat kay Wally as Lola Lindora sa kalyasyere ng Ibulaga, alam niyo bang may mabigat din palang pinagdadaanan itong si Wally? May cancer kasi ang isa niyang daughter, pero ngayon ay on the road to recovery na siya. Sa kanya daw, kumukuha ng lakas si Wally para masiguradong everyday ay marami siyang taong nagpapasaya. Way to go, Wally, and get well soon sa daughter mo. Sino ba bang bald celebrities ang idol ninyo? Tweet niyo sa akin or tag me on Instagram at @officialtimyak. I-guess natin sila dito. Tapos si Rosa, papakalbo ko na rin. Joke lang. Yak next ang ating guest. Sanay na sa pagpapaganda ng celebrities at iba pang high profile clients. Ano kaya ang bago sa mundo ng cosmetic surgery and enhancement? Tanungin natin siya when Timyak Show returns. Ikaw! Welcome back to the Tinyak Show. Ang guest natin for tonight is a napaka-respected na doctor na nagbabalik from the US. Ladies and gentlemen, the very controversial Dr. Pai Calayan. Hello,
hi.
Doc. How are you?
I'm good.
Long time no see.
Yes. Oh, diba? Ganda naman ng set mo, diba?
Oh, diba? Hindi, ito talaga. Kama ko talaga to. Welcome to my bedroom.
Should I remove my...
No, please feel
okay,
free.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yes. Oh, so, kamusta? Alam mo, maraming nag-uusap, diba? So many things surrounded your absence from the scene,
yes,
diba? You were once very, very visible.
Uh-huh.
Tapos, then you went to the U.S.,
mm-mm,
right?
Yeah.
So, it was Dr. Manny who manned the business here.
Uh-huh.
So, what happened in your... How long was your absence?
Ay, nako, 5 years. Kasi, tinapos ko yung high school ng mga bata doon. Magmula panganay hanggang bunso.
Ah, so that was what you did?
Yes.
Like, see, alam mo, maraming mga nagsasabi na, may nangyari sa operation, may her face got deformed. Tapos, she stayed there and hiwalay na sila ni Doc Manny.
Mm-mm.
You know, a lot of talk.
Yes.
So, ano ba talaga ang totoo?
Which is nakakatawa talaga. When we hear it, yung mga bata or yung mga patients doon, naririnig namin, natatawa na lang kasi nakikita naman na hindi. Oo, so it's really that I went to the States kasi mag-aaral yung mga bata doon. I'm the mom naman na medyo tutok. Gusto ko tutok eh. I don't want them to live sa relatives kahit meron doon or have their own apartment kasi high school pa. But now they're in college na, yung isa nasa Vancouver. So okay na.
So yun lang, hinintay mo lang talaga sila makapag-college before you went back to answer anything about your marriage, about your business,
yes,
about yourself.
Yes, actually I go back and forth naman. Kaya alam, minsan 1 week lang ako dito.
Tapos
kailangan bumalik doon agad.
But you've also changed your hair.
Yes.
You changed your look. When I first saw you, I didn't recognize. Oh my God, it's Pai. Yeah. So what was the reason behind this change of look?
Change of look? Kasi... peg ko si Kris Jenner nung nasa States ako. So,
diba?
Talagang ganun na ganun yung hair ko noon.
Exactly.
Pagbalik ko dito naman, medyo mas mahaba yun. So, I had to cut it dito. Naging parang pixie na.
Okay, so now that your kids are in college, ano naman ang thrust? What is your, ano mga gusto mong gawin na ngayon?
Ah, ngayon, I'm so busy with, of course, our show, May Health Cetera, kami airing on GMA News TV every Sunday, 9 to 9:30 a.m.
Okay.
And then we have this, I have the YouTube channel produced by Viva Films.
Mm.
It's Dr. Pai Calayan's Beauty and Wellness channel, so they can watch. It's like having a free consultation every time.
Okay.
And they can subscribe. And then I also do, of course, yung mga TV guests to promote mga show.
Yes.
And then marami kasi kaming mga non-surgical machines na bago talaga.
Because science these days, science and technology, napakabilis.
Oo.
Ano ba ang pinaka-advanced at pinaka-safe na gamitin na lahat ng mga tao? I mean, di ba kasi napakarami na ngayon
Oo nga, yeah. Actually, yung Dublo laser, that's the most recommended, highly recommended. Kasi nagamit na namin yung pareho ni Doc. And it's very safe, non-invasive, instant lift.
Ano ba yun yung mga PicoSure, RevLite, di ba marami mga machines that a lot of doctors use also? Ano yun? Is that in the same category?
Yung category ng PicoSure siya ka RevLite is more of pigmentations naman. The Dublo, we're concentrating on lifting.
Okay.
Para non-surgical facelift. Kasi not all patients naman goes to our clinic gusto agad surgery, di ba? Sometimes they want to maalis lang yung konting nagsasag dito, or laugh line, konting lift.
So the majority of your patients are of what the no, of what demographic? Ano yung mga gusto nilang gawin sa mga itsura nila?
Most of them, kung surgery, they want of course nose, eye bags, eyelid surgery. Tapos susunod na dyan yung mga breast augmentation and liposuction. Pag derma naman, nandiyan lagi yung pecas, yung mga pigmentations, yung mga brown spots sa face, di ba? And then acne. Nandiyan na rin yung mga birthmark removal.
So your time in the US, you also built your business there, right?
Yes.
Dinevelop ninyo yung the Calayan surgery centers there in the US.
Mm-mm.
How is business in the US?
In the US is okay. Syempre mga patients namin doon mga Pinoy pa rin talaga.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm also hands-on. Kaya lang when I needed to go back here in Manila for good na nung January, we had to close it na kasi pag walang magma-manage, siguradong wala nang pupunta.
So, anong difference naman for you practicing in the U.S. and practicing here?
Practicing in the U.S., super hands-on. As in, I receive the calls, I make the appointments. Kasi madali, may system ka doon. It's so easy for me. Kaya lang, syempre, I can manage my time there kasi mama ko sa morning, di ba? I clean the house first, everything cook before I go to the clinic. Pagdating sa gabi naman, medyo mas may time to relax. Napansin ko pagdating doon.
Ah, so kasi dito, hindi natatapos ang trabaho. Sa gabi, tuloy-tuloy pa rin, yeah, di ba?
Parang
10-11. Functions.
Oo, tapos meron ka pang iniisip na ano kayang gagawin, anong mga, may mga magte-text pa sa'yo at night. At like doon, medyo tumitigil na yung phone by 7.
Oo, kasi doon, kumbaga, they respect the personal time with your family. So alam nila that never to call you after a certain time.
Ang maganda pa doon, kasi di ba bonding kami ng mga kids, ang ginagawa namin during our free time, kasi yung isang anak ko is vegan, talagang nag-formulate or nag-concoct kami ng mga dietary food talaga, yung mga way of cooking for her vegan lifestyle. Kaya pati ngayon, sinasama ko yun doon sa Health Cetera. May portion doon, it's called Healthy Plate. At saka doon sa YouTube channel.
Ah, wow. So para naging mas holistic pa yung bonding time mo with the
kids. Yes, oo. Sabi nga nila, Ma'am, parang chef ka na ngayon, hindi na derma. I go, pwede na rin.
Oh, but see, it all goes along with your gospel of health.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Diba? Oo. And were you happier that you're bonding and having a quiet time? Kasi dito, puro chismis, diba? Mm-hmm. Every time you guys come here, parang may chismis na naka-attach sa inyo.
Oo. Actually, sanay na. Even when we were here, na masanay na. When we left, masanay na lalo. Lalong nasanay. Kasi, di ba, it's like, sabi nga ni Doc, kung hindi ka sikat, hindi ka pag-uusapan. Okay, fine. Okay.
So, kung hindi natanggap mo na yun.
Oo, pag hindi naman totoo, hayaan mo na.
So, very good, you know. But you've always been very zen-like in your approach sa mga ganyan-ganyan, di ba?
Yes, I really
don't. From day one, from the first time I met you, you've always been kalmado.
Oo, I really don't like go out and fight them or attack them sa mga issues kasi it's for them to see naman and ayoko naman na ako yung maapektuhan at ako yung ma-wrinkle, di ba?
Oo nga. Kasi galing yung mga pinagsasabi nila about you guys.
I don't know kasi alam mo naman lagi there's always somebody or someone or group of people who would like to always pull you down,
yes,
especially when you're on top.
Okay, ayun. So very good attitude and I'm sure a lot of people has something to learn from that kind of attitude because everybody's facing something similar, diba?
Yes, that's true. Basta, keep calm and go forward.
Keep calm and keep on doing what you love doing. Yes. Alam mo, marami pa tayong pag-uusapan about beauty and wellness and the things about Dr. Pai Calayan's life. Kato mga yan, pag-uusapan ko doon. Continue. Welcome back to the show. Kasama natin si Dr. Pai Calayan. Okay, so now that you are back, back in the Philippines, ano mga next goals of Dr. Pai Calayan?
It's my parang mission or ano talaga na kailangan I would like to tell the women to take care of themselves. Parang nobody will take care of you, di ba? Kasi syempre usually if you're like dalaga, tapos nag-asawa ka, you take care of your kids, your husband. Pag tumanda na kayo, if you don't take care of yourself, talagang wala. You'll age, nakikita mo naman parang napabayaan na. But if you really take care of yourself through proper eating, exercise, and holistic approach to health, talagang makita mo your approach to life is even better.
So you get that calm that you have right now.
Yes.
You have this sense of peace. How do you think, how do you react to people, because of course you're a doctor and you do medical procedures on clients, when they scrutinize you, when they look at you and they, you know that they're looking at every inch of your face and try to see, ano ginawa niya dito? Ano ginawa niya dito?
I'm actually flattered kasi pag tinanong naman nila, what procedure have you done? I don't hide naman na nagpaalis na ako ng eye bags. No, pinanganak yung bunso ko, which is 20 years ago.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. And then, they ask naman kung ano, meron na bang mga fillers dyan? Or ano, syempre, Botox, you have to do some Botox dito and yes, here, yes. Diba?
So, for example, if you don't mind me asking you, yeah. What have you done, say, Kuwari, to your face right now?
Aside from the eye bags, yes. Of course, regular Botox kailangan yes. talaga yun. Oh. Yeah. And of course, the Duplo laser for mm-hmm. instant non-surgical face lift.
Ayan, kaya nga fresh. Yeah.
Yes, and diba? Of course, regular peeling talaga.
Peeling is very yes. important.
Very important to get rid of the dead skin cells, to prevent the fine lines, para fresh lagi.
That's wonderful. And what are the other non-surgical thing, activities that you are into? Of course, now you're into cooking also. Uh-huh.
Yeah,
said?
Cooking and of course, dun sa Fit for You, dun sa etc. I've tried surfing na rin, pinasok
wow.
ko na rin, of course. Oh, and diba? Of course, Pilates, which I've been doing before, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yun. Yeah.
Wow.
And later on, we'll shoot episodes pa for Zumba. Wow.
Wow, so total yes. health and wellness. Ano? You became a health and wellness geek.
Yes, and ano nga, diba, meron din dun portion about holistic medicine. Yung mga approaches like mga halamang gamot, medicines oh. that you can, the plants that you can use at home.
Okay, so now you've gotten into that also.
Yes.
Wow.
I'm actually more into holistic na talaga, like in the clinic. Yung products namin are plant-based. I try to avoid chemicals as much as possible.
Wow, so where did this newfound interest and curiosity come from?
It's actually from my daughters kasi nga nung nasa States kami, yung naging vegan sila, di ba? So from there, since they're vegan, ang dami ng mga like new lifestyle, new even yung mga chemicals.
And even in the US, lahat. Everybody's so conscious of those things,
yes,
di ba?
Yes, so... I thought nga mahirapan kami pagdating dito kasi yung supply, sabi namin, okay, where do we get those things? Kala namin magpapaship pa kami. Pero so far, okay naman. We're trying to get those supplies.
So it's like the Calayans go organic.
Yes.
Ganon.
And holistic.
And holistic. Okay, now it's time to play some games. Okay, so the game is Don't Hide, Don't Lie. Mm-hmm. We have a set of people that you need to tell us what improvements they need. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Okay.
So let's start with, okay, our president.
Okay,
ano
wow.
Ano kailangan niyang gawin?
Ako, I would go for, of course, hair transplant.
Okay.
And eye bag removal. Mm-hmm. And tightening of the hair, mid-face and the neck.
Okay, yon. Yeah. So, Pino, if you're watching, you know what to do. Juan Tamad.
Oh, dito naman...
Si Chef Cadayona.
More of, ano lang, sa eye bags din. When he smiles kasi may konti na.
Oo. Surgical, non-surgical?
Pwede pang, pag medyo malaki na, surgical na eh.
Ah, ganun, surgical. Tapos, hindi na babalik yung eye bags mo, ganun?
Matagal. Yung iba tumatagal ng 10, 15 years.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Mine is more than, mine is 20 years na.
Oh. Yeah. So, sino gagawa yun? Sino yun? Si Doc Manny?
Yeah, siya yung one.
Talaga? Kung sa'yo naman, siya naman gagawa. I mean, kung baliktad naman, ikaw naman ang gagawa sa kanya.
Kung punderma lang, pero kung surgery, hindi.
So, you guys have the doctors to do it to each
yes.
other?
Yes.
Sarap din naman nun. Guys, I'll do that to you. You do it to me.
Yeah. Yeah, like the Duplo nga eh, sabi ko. Okay, you have to do na this part. Kailangan ng, ano, i-lift na ng konti. So, ginawa niya yung Duplo sa akin. And I did a Duplo to him.
Diba? Ang tawag doon, Duplo job. Diba? Diba? Paano naman kay Yaya Dub? Ano naman yung gagawin natin sa kanya?
Dito mukhang wala pa naman. Okay lang. Unless when she's not smiling, baka konti dito sa jaws.
Sa jawline, gano'n? Ayun, okay. Thank you. So what is your advice to people who always think, should I do it, should I not do it? Should I do it, should I not do it? You know, kasi meron pa rin yung mga iba na natatakot to go under cosmetic procedures because, yun nga, may mga horror stories from the past.
Yes.
Dahil hindi pa advanced ang technology noon.
Yeah.
But now it's much more advanced, right? And easier and more painless.
Yes. Of course, go first for non-surgical. Siyempre, when you consult the doctor, mas maganda yung word of mouth, yung referral ng friends, relatives. And then, as the doctor, personally, kung if you need surgery na talaga or non-surgical. Kasi if you're young pa naman, kaya pa na non-surgery, always go for non-surgical. And of course, when you go through all those procedures, you have to really maintain by proper management ng food, yung intake mo, workout, and of course, your outlook in life.
Okay, o diba? Talaga, good vibes yan. Well, thank you so much to Fairmont Hotel Makati for being the home of the Team Up Show Season 7. And we have something for you. Dr. Pai from Kumori Japanese Cheesecake.
Oh,
Zach
Pardini
Toothpaste.
Yes.
And from Cream Factory.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yun.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for being here. Thank alam mo, nakaka-good vibes. You know, like, after whatever people say, alam mo ang katotohanan.
Yes, of course.
The truth will set you free. And this truth has given you the sense of peace and calm that I am feeling right now.
Yes, nakakaano, di ba? Very contagious yun.
Exactly. Oh, ayun.
Yes.
Again, maraming salamat.
Can I thank some of my sponsors?
Of course.
V Kitchen Manila, Fitness Gourmet, Jing Moni Salon, Dr. Missy Navales for my dental care, Arma Salon for my makeup, Pat Santos for my clothes. Thank you so much.
Yun. Lagi ko sinasabi, dapat laging good vibes para laging good night. Samson Dr. Hi, Calayan. You are watching Good Night.